Hi guys, here again with another deck. This time I'm going to be playing Temur Tron. It's a list that I've been working on. I'm not sure it's very good, but we're going to try it out all the same. Well, you got the full set of Tron lands right here. You got Shimmering Grottos to be able to mana fix to use for your blue, your green, or your red. Mountain, because there's more red cards. Mana symbols than the rest, and also just being able to like lightning bolt and that kind of stuff makes it a lot easier against the more aggressive decks. And then we've got Haunted Fingraff, which is used to bring back creatures. We got three Firebolts, being able to kill creatures early, slow the other decks down. Two lightning bolts. These can also be an alternate win condition to just burn them out real quick. You got four Ancient Stirrings, which is to just find either your one of Ulamog's Crusher or any of your mana fixing or Tron lands. Then you've got four Chromatic Seer's Core, Chromatic Stars to fix mana, four Expedition Maps to grab the last piece of Urza Tron. Then you've got a Moment's Peace for the aggressive decks. Then you got place that Phantasmal Image, Prophetic Prism, to use to fix mana and to fix colors, as well as you draw a card. Most of the cards in this deck actually draws. Three Seagate Oracles, four Moldrifters, Fangraff Marauders are good for gaining life, and good finishers with Ulamog Crusher and Rolling Thunder. You got Circle of Protection green against the Elf decks and Mono Green Stompy. Circle of Protection white for, red for burn, mainly. One Ray of Revelations for the Boggle decks, as well as it could be used for the possibly the Mono White Heroics deck. Four Fire Blasts for control decks, three Ancient Grudges for Affinity, two Earth Rifts for the Mirror Match, more for aggressive decks, and then two Relics for Graveyard. Alright, well that's the deck. Let's see how it works out. I'm excited to see you guys in round one. Hello guys, this is match two. I forgot to turn on the recording for match one, so we're going to start on match two. I lost to Mono Red Burn in the first match. I just didn't keep aggressive enough hands, and he would kill me before I had a chance to put everything together. This hand looks fine. It has two pieces plus the Expedition map, Shimmering Grotto to put the to change the colors if I need to. I'm gonna keep this. Against Slivers, I think I should be able to put it together fast enough that this shouldn't be too bad of a matchup. Get rid of the infect sliver right here. Thank you. That one's actually pretty good. Because of flanking, blocking right now would not be a good idea, so I'm just gonna let this go. Just gonna block and hope he doesn't have removal. Movement's Peace, which is good against these Tile decks. I think that's it. This looks fine. Luckily, these Mulliganing to fly. Thank you. right. Gonna add a blue. Play this to be able to lightning bolt if he plays a predator. Okay, so crack this using these two lands. Then I've got seven, move one to the green to play this, then gain five life. Have the ability to gain five life. Alright, sounds good. I'm just going to play the Ulmox Crusher, play some more of these, have the ability to gain more life, and then the game should be over pretty soon here. We're just gonna run this back. Alright, so yeah, this hand's just terrible. I mean, it's not terrible. It's one land away from being good, but I can't keep this. Alright, I can keep this. Ancient Stirrings on turn 2. Try to put together some land to do a Rolling Thunder, kill most of this board. He had a mulligan again to 5, so again, this puts me like pretty far ahead. Mulliganing 4. Put this to the bottom. Quite a bit away from casting it. From Mulliganing 4, that's a pretty good start. I'm gonna start off by cracking this to a green, using Ancient Stirrings. The other option is just to play the Grotto, use Firebolt to kill that. But with him not having that many cards in hand, I just want to kind of put stuff together as quickly as possible. And I'm a dumbass that made it to go to red, like an idiot. So I guess I will Firebolt, and then play land and drop this sphere. Mistake prone today. Sadly, I don't get a second piece to Tron, even going through 6 cards, so I'm gonna grab another Urza Mine to make sure I keep hitting my land drops, and hopefully I draw one in the next couple turns so I can just use the map to get the last piece. Start off with Ancient Stirrings again. Now I can go get the last piece at the end of turn, and then next turn I can start doing a bunch of stuff. Make another mistake. I mean, is it really surprising I made another mistake. I'm getting way too antsy. I need to calm down. Just play right. Can I burn them out? I have 6 in hand, 2 in the graveyard, which means I would need 12 more, and with Rolling Thunder, I can do 7, 9 next turn. Okay, we'll just... just wait this out. We'll use Firebolt this turn, and then at the end of his turn, we might Lightning Bolt him twice. Okay, so next turn I will have 6 with this Urza Mine hand, 9, 13, this is going to create one of the reds that I need, and then use one of those to go to 12. Alright, so even if the Mole Drifter gets killed, I'll kill him next turn with the Rolling Thunder. Nice. Well, even with mistakes, it's still one. But yeah, I'm just terrible at this deck so far. Hopefully I don't make less mistakes than the other rounds. Alright, we'll go to round three. All three Tron pieces and stuff to do. This is a great hand, I'm definitely keeping. They Mulligan to five, so I'm just getting lucky. Is clear. Hopefully I draw a big threat. If not, it's gonna be like Seagate Oracle into all of these. counterspell is in their hand. Gotta watch out for that later. Alright, Angler's a really good draw, so I gotta put this together to beat this. Thank you. got two cards in hand. That's not good. I'm probably going to win this race just for the fact that I can gain life. I don't think he can. I also have two lightning bolts in hand, but we'll see. That changes the math a little bit. Bullmog's Crusher! Alright, so I have the damage in my hand to be able to kill him, so I am just gonna swing with everything, let him sacrifice some stuff, block a few, and then from that point I'll try burning him out. Okay, Firebolt's not that good in this matchup, so we're gonna take those three out. Bring Pyroblast in. Bring in Relics. Take out one lightning bolt, or both lightning bolts, or do I take out any? Yeah, both lightning bolts. Yeah, let's run it like that. Try this. I have a lot of draw, and when I get to the second land, it'll help me out a lot. So I'm gonna try this out. Alright, I feel like we're in a pretty good position. Gonna run out this Mold Drifter first. Thank you. Okay. I want to see if I can draw a Fire Blast to force through one of these Ulamogs. But the next two turns we're going to be basically trying to cast Ulamogs. Change plan, I'm gonna go Fengren into Mold Drifter to expand it because I can cast both this turn. Surprised that I didn't have a counter. And I have a Fire Blast for next. This result. That's fine. Thank you. Alright guys, well, that worked out in my favor. Let's go on to match 4. If I can win at least one of the last two, then I get prizes, which is all I look forward to doing when I play these leagues, is if I keep getting prizes, keep building new decks, and getting better. Alright, round 3. Match 4 technically, but round 3 of the ones you guys are going to see. Well, the other two rounds I won because the people had to mulligan significantly in at least one of their games, so let's see if I can actually play the deck well and win on my own merits. So, let's go. I will keep this hand because that has a lot of draw, and if I get a few more lands, these Mole Drifters are probably going to be pretty good. Another blue-black control deck. So I just need to start dumping threats out there to get through the counter spells and everything else. First thing I'm going to do is invoke this Mole Drifter, draw a few cards, and try to get more threats in my hand. With this. I need some more land though. Thank you. Alright, second Tron piece. Actually cool with that because I'm gonna be casting Moldrifter next turn and he's either gonna counter it, but one of the counter spells out of his hand. He went bottom top with that priority. Pressure is on now. So, I think I'm actually, can I do that? I'm going to kill the Germanic Angler, because I just need, I can use all 8 of mana, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, then transfer one of the 7 to red, actually no, 7, cast, yeah, I can't kill it this turn, so I think I'm going to play Moldrifter, and Prism, and then next turn see what he does in response. Does Fire Blast make it? I think I can kill it now with Fire Blast. Okay, I'm gonna kill it then. Thank you. Okay, so let's 8, 10, 12. Gotta float one, so 11. I could kill both these guys, or I can kill this guy and play a Seagate Oracle. I think that's what I'm gonna do. Play. All right, let's play Seagate Oracle first. Alright, that buys me turn, and also, I feel like that helps me out, but we'll see. I'm in a pretty bad spot. He can pretty much sort through. The only way that I can possibly start recovering is if Ulmuk survives for a few turns. Bottom top of Pyridane, so we'll see what. Yep, there we go. I'm gonna run out of time. Need to play faster. Yeah, his card selection is just far better than mine, and I didn't get out ahead of it. Though this is a lot closer than I thought it would be. I'm gonna try just whittling him down and then Rolling Thunder him. Just trying to buy some time now. Alright, that makes it so I can't win. taking everything out, I mean, bringing back in Pyroblast and all these, taking out Firebolts, Lightning Bolt, and Moment Speed. I'm gonna keep this because I'm pretty close to Tron. It's a shame I have to get a Shimmering Grotto just to be able to cast spells next turn. Still no tower. Thank you. even if I do win this game, I don't think I'm going to have enough time to win a game 3. It took too long to play, and lag is really killing my time. Come on, tower. That is not a tower. So I think it's tower or bust this turn. If I get a tower, then I get Haunted Fingraph and cast maybe two spells this turn to be able to not get just Chainer's Edict out of the game. Alright, let's go on to match 5. Alright guys, here for round 5. I'll keep. Thank you. Alright, I feel like we're in a good position, so as long as they don't, like, go crazy, we should do pretty well. I'm not gonna attack this turn. I don't want him double blocking me, get rid of the thing graph, especially now that I have an expedition map to crack next turn, so I'm gonna just wait a turn before doing anything. I could clear board a little bit with burn spells next turn as well. Nice, easy one. Post sideboard, I'm gonna bring in a few Ancient Grudge.